Hi, I'm Jesse McCrosky, a data scientist and researcher with the Mozilla Foundation, and I'm here to talk to you about how YouTube decides what content is best for you. In our previous video, we talked about how YouTube uses information about its content, about the user, and about the context to decide which videos to recommend to you. But what do they mean by best? To really dig into this, we need to understand that YouTube's content recommendation engine is an artificial intelligence system, and artificial intelligence systems are governed by metrics. For example, in a previous video in this series, my colleague Becca Ricks was explaining what an artificial intelligence system is. She gave the example of a system designed to recognize if a picture was of a dog or a cat. In this case, we say that the system is optimizing for accuracy. What this means is it's evaluated by how accurately it's making its decisions. How many of the dog pictures is it classifying as dogs, and how many of the cat pictures are classified as cats. So for a content recommendation engine to be able to recommend the best content, we need to decide on a metric to measure what content is best. YouTube states that their recommendations help you discover more of the videos that you love. Recommending videos that users will love is a good conceptual goal, but it needs to be measured with a real metric. And this is where the story takes a twist. To explain this, let's talk about pay-per-click advertising. A platform may claim that they just want to show you the ads that are most useful to you. But measuring usefulness is really difficult. One approach they might take is to assume that if a user clicks on an ad, that ad is useful to that user. But there are many ways to trick users into clicking on ads that are not going to be useful or interesting for them. So if the platform is measuring usefulness using clicks, they're really just incentivizing the behavior that makes them money. YouTube is quite similar. According to a paper that some YouTube engineers published in 2019, YouTube optimizes for both engagement and user satisfaction. This is an oversimplification, but basically engagement is the same thing we were just talking about. How many videos do you watch, click on, and how much time do you spend on the YouTube platform? User satisfaction measures the feedback that users provide. Do they click on that thumbs up button? Do they share the video with their friends? Things like that. But they admit in the paper that they optimize mostly for engagement. So really, they're just showing you whatever videos are most likely to keep you on the platform, watching more videos and seeing more ads. Remember from our last video how optimization works. We had the example of the cat and dog recognizing AI that optimizes for accuracy. Similarly, YouTube is optimizing for engagement. It's mathematically discovering which videos to show to you to keep you on the platform as long as possible. So YouTube is using all this data they've collected about you, and their incredibly sophisticated artificial intelligence systems focused on one goal, to get you to watch more videos, even if these videos are misinformation, conspiracy theories, or even just a waste of time, like silly cat videos. No offense to cat lovers. Of course, we still make choices. We all have free will, and we all decide when and where we watch YouTube. But the best metaphor I've heard for this kind of manipulation is tilting the floor. Of course, people are still free to walk wherever they want, but if you tilt the floor enough, more and more people are going to end up in the pit. The problem is that YouTube has become such a fundamental part of our society. A recent study showed that 72% of US adults see YouTube as a source of news. Increasingly, we get our news, conduct our civic discourse, and participate in our democracies on these large platforms controlled by enormous corporations. If we're going to allow these platforms to play this essential role in society, we need to care a lot more about what they're designed to do, who they're designed by, and whether this design is truly meeting the needs of our societies.